Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO DVC Technology, and I've got one I'm really excited about today. A while back, you may have noticed that they came out with an AI DSLR lens, which is basically a micro four-thirds camera with removable lenses that works in the Unifi system. I've really wanted to get my hands on one of these, and thank you to Unifi, they sent me one over. I'm gonna throw it up on the rig, we're gonna poke it, we're gonna prod it. We're gonna see who this lens is for. Obviously, this is not an inexpensive camera and lens, and let's see how it really performs during the day, during the night, and how it does with AI detections. So without any further mumbling, let's throw it up on the building and let's see what we get. First, let me start by thanking Unifi for sending over this unit. I've wanted to review this unit for a long time. Let's talk about the elephant in the room. This is a very expensive unit at $24.99. Obviously, that's a lot of money, but when you look at the build quality of this unit and what you're getting here, it starts to be a little bit more compelling. The camera and enclosure for this unit are really well built, but just the lens alone, and I got the 45 millimeter for my kit, he is $1,399 if he went to B&H and bought it today. So more than half of the price of this unit is just in the glass. And then you have a micro four thirds camera, really nice camera, and a really heavy duty enclosure for this unit. So obviously this is kind of like the G4 PTZ Industrial, where this is a very high-end unit, it's for a very specific use case, but the build quality and optic of this unit and for the G4 PTZ Industrial are really, really top-notch. But what you're getting here conceivably with this Micro Four Thirds though is a much bigger sensor. So this is a 10 megapixel sensor. In Protect, that 10 megapixel image is sampled down to an 8 megapixel image. So basically this Micro Four Thirds sensor is a much bigger sensor than you're gonna get in a regular security surveillance camera. This is basically a DSLR type of where you can remove the lens type of camera. So for sensor sizes, you have Micro Four Thirds and you have ASPC, and then you have a full frame sensor. So when you're looking at this lens, it's basically a 2x crop over a full frame camera sensor. So basically when you take a 45 millimeter lens, you have to double that length to get your actual length. So my 45 millimeter lenses on this camera is actually basically the equivalent of a 90 millimeter lens if you had it on the Sony that I'm shooting on right now. Same thing with the 17 millimeter. So there's a wide option for this that you can get from Unifi. That lens will be the equivalent of a 35 millimeter lens if you were on a full frame. The advantage of this bigger sensor over a regular surveillance camera sensor size sensor, obviously it's bigger, so you're gonna get more information, you're gonna get a better image. But the other thing is that it lets in more light. So your low light capability of this sensor is much higher than a smaller camera. So it's the same reason that when you take your cell phone and you try to take a picture at night of the moon versus using the camera that I'm using right now to take a shot of the moon, it's just an order of magnitude better, because in those low light conditions, it's basically just the laws of optics. The more light that you have hit that sensor, the easier it is for that sensor to create the image. So saying that, that's the reason that this is such an expensive camera. But you know, if you looked at a Micro Four Thirds camera with this lens, just a regular, Olympus camera out there, you start to say the $24.99 for the setup is probably about right in line for what you're getting here from a quality standpoint. So what does all that mean in real life? Let's jump into the software real quick and I'm gonna show you the difference. I'm gonna compare this a little bit to the AI Pro. I'm gonna show you why I got this camera, what I'm gonna use it for, and why for some specific instances, this may be the exact right camera for you. So let's jump into the software real quick. All right, so let's jump right in here. This is the AI DSLR. You can see this is an amazingly tack sharp image. It's pretty incredible. And one of the things about this bigger sensor, it just gives you the ability to do digital zoom. Like if you had an image with a big sensor in a DSLR, you're able to zoom. So if you have a 40 megapixel, 30 megapixel, 20 megapixel camera, you're able to zoom in. And a 10 megapixel camera on a surveillance system gives you that same differential. Yeah, I wouldn't zoom in that far on a regular image from a regular surveillance camera and expect to get this kind of sharpness still be display. So if I move this around a little bit, we can go in here and just really see so much detail. So basically up on the top, we've got shortcuts, we've got detections. Here we're getting face, person, vehicle, vehicle type, vehicle color, license plate, animal, and there's this new confidence level. I'm on an early release version of the software. By the time you see this video, you will probably have that as well. But anyways, a confidence level will show you the recognitions and tell you what percent the system thinks that it is confident that it's hitting those recognitions. Whether that's a white van, it'll say a white van, 99.9% that it's white, which is a cool feature, pretty interesting, especially for license plate detection. And I will tell you, for me and my instance, that is the killer feature that I'm after here. I wanted to be able to reliably catch every license going in and out of my driveway. Obviously, this is more zoomed in. It's very tight, but it is an incredibly sharp image for the zoom that it is. We're in Florida. There's only rear license plates needed here. So basically, we're really trying to get every one of them as they leave. And you can see there, as the cars went by, that confidence interval on the color of the vehicles. It was a pretty interesting new feature. So anyways, there's that. And then there's adjust focus. I've got my focus set right to here, but you can adjust where the camera is focusing. If I wanted a little bit further in the screen, I could do that. There's a really deep focal plane for this camera. So I don't really see that there's much difference in my tuning on that, but obviously you could tune it right into exactly where it is. Now, I think if something was really close to this or really far away, that may make a bigger difference, but it is there if you need it, and that's a nice feature. So we can also take a snapshot, which is really cool. One of the things about this, and I don't know how it's gonna come across on YouTube, is this is a really, really sharp image. So when you take a snapshot, it really looks like a nice, nice image, and you can zoom into it. It has all that detail, and you can really zoom in to see it all. And then there's image tuning, just like all the others, where you can now change all this stuff in here. I'm running with all the defaults. If I go into advanced, I could change all these things. If I wanted to, I could rotate it. I could change frequency and I could do all the other things here. Right out of the box, you can see that this image is phenomenal. So I don't really need to do much there. And it's got two-way talk. Obviously, I've got the cover on it. So it says device audio suppressed due to waterproof cover being attached. So if that's a feature that you're looking for, you can run this with or without, obviously, that enclosure. This being outside, I'm running it with the enclosure. And so it's telling you there that it is suppressing that audio. All really cool features. Some of those are features that are new to Protect. So check that you're on the latest version to have them, and we'll go from there. Obviously, if you're buying an AI DSLR, you probably are somebody that updates your firmwares. You can see how narrow this field of view is. I have the 45 millimeter lens, which is a 90 millimeter equivalent in a full frame. There is a 17 millimeter, which is a 35 millimeter equivalent. You can see the zoom differences based on the other cameras that I've got here. I've got the BTZ, I've got the G5 Turret Ultra, and then I've just got a regular G5 dome here in the front door. So let's dive into what I feel like is the really killer feature for my application here. And that's gonna really revolve around, do I really want the best image quality, which is gonna give me the best AI detections? Or do I need low light capability without any added light to also do AI detections? And so let's jump into AI detections. It's under recognition here in the software. And you can see I've got license plates already pulled up here. I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna put AI DSLR and I'm gonna go my AI Pro. This is gonna be a pretty fair comparison because both of these are mounted in the same spot. You can see here that I am nabbing every license plate that comes and goes from my office. You can see in a 2-hour period, I've got, what's that? That's 15 detections in 1 hour. That is everybody that has come and left my parking lot, which is awesome. The AI Pro is great and it got most everybody, but this gets everybody, which is incredible. You could just see the quality of that. Obviously, his confidence intervals are going to be super high here, but look at that license plate. There's just no doubting that it was going to grab that. I tell everybody the way that AI works in Unifi cameras is if you can see it with your eyes, it's going to detect it. If you cannot see it or read it with your eyes, it will not detect it. I mean, obviously, that's just the laws of optics, and the computer can't invent something that's not there, but basically, its eyes are as good as your eyes. So when you see something that clearly, you're going to get that every single time. And it is just incredible. So a use case scenario one is if you had a gate or a driveway and you want to know every person that's coming in, that is where this camera just absolutely knocks it out of the park. And you can see the image quality every time is just phenomenal. And the other thing about it is you're able to use that zoom. I'm digital zoom at 500% here. I can't think of another camera where I could go and digital zoom at 500%. And get it. Now the G4 PTZ Industrial, I've got optical zoom and it will do similar, but it doesn't have that AI capability of these detections. So I obviously have this in a spot where I am doing license plate detections. If you had an internal spot where you, or an external spot where you wanted to do face detections, I don't have a lot of faces that are coming into this frame, so I don't have it to test, but very similar. Its hit rate is going to be through the roof just because of the quality and the clarity of the image. I'm thinking about the new access gate feature where you're able to activate the gate automatically through license plate detection. Well, that's a spot where this would be amazing. You know, automated, nobody has to be there to do anything else. It just lets you in based on your license plate. This device will detect that license plate all the time, every time. The other big thing is low light. There's this function when you go outside with a digital camera, especially a nice digital camera, like the one that I'm shooting on right now. If you go outside with this camera, it will see more at night than you will with your eyes. So it will be darker to you than it will be to the camera. And that's the way this camera works. So now my front area, as I've said in all my other videos, has lighting out there. And I'll show you what it looks like in darkness with my AI Pro. But this looks in complete darkness like there is still ambient light out. This is completely dark. The only lights that are coming from the street lights, my lights in the parking lot are off. But there are lights in the building to the left and there are lights in the building to the right. I mean, it's just incredible. And that's very, very easy to read that license plate. Now you'll see at darkness, no matter what, again, laws of optics and laws of physics, this is grainier than it is during the day. There's just less light hitting the sensor. But I'm gonna grab that license plate almost every time with this sensor, which is amazing. So that second case use case for me is if it's at night and you still want to be able to have recognitions, this camera is an order of magnitude more efficient than anything else that I've ever seen. It is really crazy. And that image is incredible. This is darkness and it looks that good. So another one at night, you know, it's completely dark out and it's dabbing plates. It's really, really cool. It is summertime here in Florida. If you don't live in Florida, and every afternoon during the summer, we get 100% humidity. It comes, it rains, and then it leaves. And then at night, it cools off. And so, but your temperature and humidity variations during the day are immense. So when I first put the enclosure on the unit, you can see that several days in a row, it fogged up. I've been around a long time, and originally when it was either the G4 Pro or the G5 Pro came, they were prone to doing this. And the remedy to it was to let them just sit for a couple of days and they will equalize. And that's what I did and it went away. But that being said, it's very difficult. You know, you're out there at a certain humidity level or you're inside when you put the unit together at a certain humidity level, you're trapping that air inside of the unit. You know, that outer enclosure is encapsulating that air in there, and that's at a certain humidity. Then you take it outside, and that humidity differential is making it fog up. And so the remedy for me was to just leave it alone for a few days and let it just kind of equalize itself, and that it did. And so I'm not getting that anymore. But just for reference, I'm gonna roll back in time a little bit, and I'm gonna go back into June when I had the AI Pro up there, and you'll see one thing is strikingly different. I'm not seeing any nighttime detections. It just doesn't grab them at night at my distance on that camera where I've got it pointed. It's just too far away to grab them at night. But I do have a few detections at night. Okay, so this is a nighttime detection, and this is what it looks like at night on the AI Pro. Now you'll see here as well, it does look lighter than it would to your naked eye. It does look like there's light here, but it's much, much darker than it is in the AI DSLR. But also, you know, I got this license plate detected here, but this vehicle you'll see is standing still for a long time. Actually moving now, but it moved into the frame, stopped, and it's going very slow, stopped right at about the distance where my AI Pro does pretty good recognitions at night. But as it gets further in here, I wouldn't have gotten that detection if he would have gone this way. I got the detection because he kind of went through this free spot on that camera. So this is a spot where I can't quite get it with an AI Pro, although the AI Pro would get it if they come along this way, but I'm getting it perfectly on that AI DSLR. And you can just see the difference in the image quality at night. Just simply, it's a bigger sensor. There's simply more light. It is just the laws of physics. Let me do this. I'm gonna go back to the top again, and I'm gonna grab one of the DPC vans that comes and goes all the time. So let's go, I'm gonna go back into detections here and I'm just gonna search AJ6. So this is one of our vans here at DPC, and you're gonna see there are gonna be some detections on the AI DSLR and there's gonna be some detections on the AI Pro. If I go in here on the AI DSLR and look at that license plate, I mean, it is just nutty how good that image is, right? Like, I mean, it's incredible. And then if I go same spot, we'll get them in the same spot, and we'll go to the AI Pro. Again, an amazing image out of the AI Pro. I mean, AI Pro is my favorite camera that we have, but you can just see the difference now. And to be fair, he's gonna get that license plate maybe all of the time here, but at that same distance, let me go one little step further. At that same distance, you know, zooming in, the quality difference is just night and day. A difference of a $1,399 lens and a much bigger sensor and a much more zoomed in focal length. But yes, it does come with that price. But I can see for certain ones of my clients who really wants the surveillance, who really wants the recognition, that this would be the perfect fit for them. I do feel for, you know, 80, 90% of the people out there that in the same location, the AI Pro is the camera to go to, and it's a great camera. But there are gonna be that 10% of those locations where you just need that extra reach, you need that extra quality, or you're dealing with lower light and you can't get any artificial light out to that location. I think all of those are locations where this camera is a good fit. Yeah, I have a feeling this is gonna be a pretty polarizing camera and a pretty polarizing review. I know I'm gonna get a lot of comments down below about, you know, this is for the ultra rich or whatever, but I do feel like this is a tool just like all the other tools that Unifi offers to us. And for a certain percentage of the people out there, I think this might be the right tool. So I would love to continue that discussion down in the comments. Any questions that you have, I'd be more than willing to answer those or anything you want me to test on it. Or if you just wanna say, that's crazy, Clay, or that's cool, put it down below. And as always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.